Hello, I'm David from Rackham Product Management Team, and today I would like to share a special moment with you. Receiving new gear always makes me want to experiment, explore the whole box, and test it out. Well, we decided to show you what to expect when the new gear is our flagship microwave link, the Ray 3. Ray 3 is one of the fastest and most reliable microwaves you can buy. It offers 1 gigabit full duplex speed and extraordinary flexibility. Ray supports channel width starting from 3.5 MHz and is possible to set it asymmetrically by software, allowing use of the whole available spectrum without any compromise. Ray also features a plenty of diagnostics and installation tools to make your life easier. If you are not familiar with it, please check out our website or technical presentation video linked in the upper right corner. Now let's begin. Ray comes in a recycled paper box. Since you usually purchase the whole link, expect 2 units snugly packed in a larger box for additional protection. By the way, the units are arranged in a way that allows for establishing a link and performing initial configuration without removing the units from the box. When you get one box out and open it, you will see the units securely fitted in with a paper spacer. We also include protective waveguide aperture caps, grease, and accessory kit. Every part of the Ray case shows extra information. For example, here at the top, you can see labels of the 2 main ports, one for Ethernet and PoE, and the other one for Ethernet or SFP. And now for the big moment. Pulling the unit out of the box, you feel its weight. The unit amasses 2.6 kg, that is 5.7 pounds for our US and UK customers, thanks to its full outdoor rugged aluminium chassis. The unit is well protected against any damage during the installation and throughout its life. The bottom side of the unit features a cleverly designed paper spacer with a quick start picture guide. The top side explains hardware installation, antenna, power and data. Bottom left side tells you how to connect the unit using various connection options, and bottom right side explains how to set correct polarization of both units. It also provides QR code leading to a complete quick guide on our website. If you're interested in unit configuration, please have a look at our Power Up tutorial video and other tutorials published here on our YouTube channel. Now, putting that aside, here is the Ray unit in all its grace. Isn't it dashing? Now, let's focus on the unit itself for a bit. The top side features a strong handle and a service port. It also serves as a passive heatsink. The service port is protected by a semi-transparent cap indicating system status by color. Green means system is up and working. Alternating red indicates warning or alarm. For example, Wi-Fi password is not set. There are other states detailed in our documentation. After unscrewing the cap, you can see a USB service connector fitted with USB to Wi-Fi adapter for easy setup and 2 RSS voltage contacts for voltmeter aided alignment. It is also possible to use an optional USB to Ethernet adapter, but we recommend using Wi-Fi to connect to the unit management. You may have noticed 4 massive mounting points on the sides, designed to securely fix the unit to the antenna and to support a variety of installation positions. Nearby, you also find the grounding screw, marked by a yellow sticker with a grounding symbol. The side of the unit across the holder is pretty flat. It features a round flange with a unit waveguide in the middle. It ensures a perfect connection of the unit to the antenna. Right side of the unit contains the product sticker listing details, warnings, and certifications. The first column lists the unit type and ordering code. You can also see the working frequency range, maximum RF power, and power supply specification. Below, you will find FCC certification. EU Declaration of Conformity is marked by a CE icon in the next column. More country-specific certifications are not printed on the tag. They can, however, be provided on request. The second column contains the serial number and our address and website. You can get to our detailed documentation by scanning the provided QR code. If I bring back the case for a bit, I can show you another product sticker on the box itself. It lists the same details but also declares compliance with EU Radio Equipment Directive 2014/53. By scanning the second QR code, you can visit a webpage explaining everything regarding safety, environment, and licensing. The bottom side is the most interesting since it houses two primary ports and a special plastic screw for pressure equalization. Please do not tamper with the screw as it can compromise the airtight unit and result in void warranty. One port is a standard gigabit Ethernet used also for PoE or DC power supply, while the right-hand one features SFP port for either a second metallic gigabit Ethernet or an optical module. We offer both types of SFPs as accessories. As already shown, part of delivery is a two-part accessory kit. First part is a plastic bag with a complete set of different plastic bushings to secure the unit against moisture when installed outside. Second is a box with silicone grease for antenna mounting, and it is provided once per link. And finally, if ordered as an optional accessory, a DC power adapter in a small paper box. Ray is a great example of expert manufacture and design by Czech engineers in Vysočina Highlands, in the heart of Europe. It is a solid piece of electronics, inspiring confidence that the unit will operate for years, which is almost certain since we currently calculate mean time between failures of Ray units to over 100 years. In case you're interested in how to set the unit up for the first time, please continue to our power-up tutorial. We are adding new tutorials regularly, so please don't forget to subscribe to get notified of our new releases. If you like what you see, get in touch with our sales team on racom.eu. Thank you and have a great day.